Tim Weber.
And what are you doing here, Tim?
I have a short film in the festival. It's called Flight.
And you just received an award from Trieste Science Fiction Festival.
I did. It was very exciting. At the beginning of the festival, they gave me an award for my body of work up to now. I've worked on a lot of big science fiction films, which has been great. And yeah, it was lovely to get the award.
What How did it make you feel?
Well, it was a great way to start the whole festival, and it was a very warm audience. It felt that the award is lovely, but the reception I got from the crowd just made me feel very happy. Yeah,
you were behind some of the most amazing visual effects in the film industry. What has been your most challenging and awarding project?
Well, definitely the most challenging is Gravity. It was so much more complex and tricky than any other film I've done, in a lot of different ways. They all came together into one film, but therefore the most rewarding. It put me at the heart of the filmmaking, as well as the rewards of overcoming the challenges. Just being right at the heart of the film made it very enjoyable, and in many ways that's what sort of encouraged me to want to move into directing, is being there at the heart of it.
And you did receive the Academy Award for it, so that was
that's always nice to get an Oscar. Yeah, the icing on the cake. Yeah.
What about Harry Potter and the Avatar?
Well, yeah, Harry Potter was fascinating. Avatar, I only came in at the end, actually. I sort of took over as it was nearing, and we were just working on one particular sequence of the film, and that was very challenging. But even in the short period of time I was on that, I learned a lot off doing that, and it was fascinating to work with James Cameron, who was he had very clear ideas of what he wanted and really knew what what needed to be done, and was good at being clear in the way he was asking for it, and it's all useful to learn, an amazingly complicated film to have worked on.
I'm sure. Tell us a little bit about the movie that is now in Trieste Science Fiction Festival.
So it's a short film called Flight, and we've used a lot of the techniques that we first used on Gravity, actually, but modern versions of the technique, so they're a little bit easier to do, It's about a young girl who is a champion airboarder, but her manager is oppressive and is kind of keeping her controlled and locked up. And it's about her attempt for freedom, her break for freedom. And it was great fun to make. It was quite challenging making something that complex on a short film budget, all sorts of restrictions, made it tricky. But again, that's what makes it fun.
Yeah. Amazing. Are there projects you're working on that we should look out for?
I'm not working on anything at the moment. I'm looking for a feature-length film to make, and it's hard to find one that fits everything, that all the requirements that we need. So we haven't quite pinned one down yet, but we're looking.
Exciting. What about the visual effects industry? Thinking 10 years from now with artificial intelligence, what do you think? How is it going to change?
Well, I think with artificial intelligence, it's hard to say where it's going to be 2 years from now, let alone 10 years from now. The rate of change over the last year, the new techniques that have come out, is just unbelievable how quickly new things have appeared. But at the moment, none of them are the sort of, people think you'll be able to type in, I want a shot of an alien on a planet with the sun setting and you'll get what you want. You can't. That's a long way from getting that. So I think in the short term, artificial intelligence will be used to speed up little bits of the process that we already do. There'll still be all the artists involved. Everyone will still be doing what they do, but they'll be able to do certain things faster. It's not going to have major changes, but it will, make small changes to the way we do things.
I can't wait to see it. So this is your first time in Trieste?
Yes, and it's lovely. What a lovely city. It's got a lovely, relaxed feel. We've been very fortunate with the weather, which is nice.